Greetings viewers, I am Double J Double M, Jeff John Mwana Mzaledo. I'll begin today's talk with a story from the Bible, the story of the Tower of Babel, which is found in the book of Genesis on the 11th chapter. I'm sure you, my viewer, you're familiar with the story. How man started building a tower to reach the heavens, and God caused them to speak different languages and shattered them and scattered them all over the world. The current Kenyan political scene reminds me of that story in the Bible. A united Kenya is no more. The only thing that we have is political and tribal interests that are being pushed by different individuals in order to achieve their own selfish goals. Unfortunately, we, the common Mwananchi, are the ones who will suffer in this confusion currently crippling our country, like it was during the scattering of the builders of the Tower of Babel. Come August, which is only 4 months away, we will be exactly 1 year from what is likely to be one of the most important general elections in our history. Meanwhile, the common Mwananchi is facing perhaps what is the most trying socio-economic time since Kenya's 58 years of independence, the coronavirus pandemic, which has battered our economy, our businesses, and it has shattered our livelihoods. Men and women who have owned many homes and properties are now selling them one by one to repay overdue loans. Men and women who have easily been paying and comfortably paying their rent throughout their adult lives are now being evicted from their houses with huge rent arrears. People are moving back to their rural homes. Others are moving into their parents' homes with their own families. We are suffering. Nowadays, in our WhatsApp groups, we do not fail to see one or two people who are calling friends, appealing them for financial help, either for a medical emergency or the need to sort other emergencies like rent arrears or even an appeal for food donation. This is now our shared common reality as citizens. However, looking at the political scene, one can be forgiven to think that we are in the middle of the most prosperous post-independence period of our lives. Our politicians appear like they are living in August 2022 and not in April 2021. They are only interested in political deals that guarantee them power and positions. Your MCA wants to become MP. Your MP wants to become the senator. Your senator wants to become the governor. But meanwhile, Wanjiku just wants to survive this pandemic. But why all these political realignments and coalition building? That we are hearing rumors now, Raila Odinga and William Ruto are looking for each other through their lieutenants and their emissaries to see if they can work together. Really? Governors like Wycliffe Oparanya of Kakamega, Hassan Joho of Mombasa, they are said to be planning to switch camps from the ODM to the Hustler Nation. Really? And even hustlers like Dismas Barasa and Boni Khalwale of Kakamega are said to be rethinking their place in Ruto's camp. The other day, we read about a lady called Nancy Gitau, an Uhuru insider, who is said to be managing the Kenyatta succession politics, even though she has no political leadership background that we can speak of. Really? Are these things really important? One thing Uhuru's father, President Jomo Kenyatta, was extremely good at was ensuring that he had his ears on the ground. He was always interested in what the ground was saying. He would summon different politicians to State House, and the first question that he would ask them was, "What are the people in your area saying?" I remember an interview where Martin Shikuku, the former MP for Butere, when he said he would get surprised when Kenyatta called him to State House, because one thing is that he was a strong critic of the Kenyatta government. But still, Kenyatta would call him to State House, and the first question that he would ask Shikuku was, "Watu wa Butere wanasema nini?" And looking at the current politicians and their obsession with political alliances, I wonder, are they really listening to what the people are saying? The current Kenyan political scene reminds me of the last years of the KANU regime in the early 2000s. That period was also similar to the final years of the great Soviet Union Republic in the 1980s, the late 1980s. The notable thing with these three situations, that is, one, the current Kenyan political scene, and two, the last years of the Khan regime, and three, the last years of the USSR Republic, was this different interest and selfish political goals quickly sucked power away from the center, leading to many breakaways, many political units breaking away, political players breaking away. Remember, during Moi's time, when we were shocked to hear Professor George Saitoti, his loyal vice president, was leaving Moi and joined NARC. What about Kalonzo's open public defiance of Moi? When these leaders began to pull away from the influential centralized authority of President Moi, Mzee had no option but to recognize that he no longer held the power and influence and over his most loyal lieutenants. Similarly, the Soviet Union, when it began to break down, when different Soviet leaders were within it, began declaring independence of their own states, they sucked power from the Moscow, and by pursuing their own nationhood, until in the end, the USSR President Gorbachev himself had to formally declare that his power, a powerful office in Moscow, was now extinct, because all the Soviets had been declared independent. Our politicians must begin to refocus their efforts for a united Kenya. And very importantly, they must start to help the suffering Wanjiku. The great Spanish philosopher, George Santayana, said, "Those who do not learn from history are doomed. They are doomed to repeat it." The current political leaders in Kenya, starting with His Excellency the President Uhuru Kenyatta, must tone down their political game. They must tone down their political gamemanship and begin thinking of ways of how to help Wanjiku. We should be hearing of mass vaccination efforts, for example, not mass rallies. We should be hearing of tax reliefs and reductions, not tax increases. We should be planning on how to safely reopen our economy, not how to input new lockdowns. You know, that way we will unite the country and prevent selfish political interests from destroying us from within. As I conclude, let me take you back to the encounter between President Jomo Kenyatta and Martin Shikuku. I told you Mzee had asked him, Shikuku, what the people of Butere were saying. And Mzee asked him using a Luya word, because I presume Mzee was interested in identifying with different people of different tribes in Kenya. So Kenyatta asked, Amacheni, which simply means, what are the people of Butere saying? And Shikuku answered very honestly that his people were saying that the government of Kenyatta was corrupt. So Mzee was astonished and he asked Shikuku, why are they saying so? Shikuku answered, because there is a local corrupt chief in Butere who had been caught receiving a bribe and he had not been fired. Well, Mzee turned away, turned and looked at Jonjo, the Attorney General, who was also present, and he asked why the chief had not been fired by then. Well, Jonjo replied to Kenyatta that there was a simple technicality which had prevented him from firing the chief. And right there, Mzee instructed the Chief Secretary, Geoffrey Kareli, that he had to call the Western Provincial Commissioner, Mr. Boyd, to immediately fire the chief in question. And once Kareli confirmed to Kenyatta that the chief had been fired, Mzee turned to Jojo and asked him if there was any other technicality. Jojo said no, and that was the end of the story. Well, you can say what you may have to say about the first president, but to me, that was an example of a great leader. That was great leadership, listening to what the people on the grassroots are saying and act accordingly. I'll leave you with these words for our leaders. What are the people on the ground saying? And are you listening? I am Double J Double M, Jeff John Mwana Mzalendo. See you next time, and remember to stay safe. Goodbye, and I've been bringing you this from the Jubo Convention Center here at the Sports View Hotel in Kasarani. Bye-bye.